being the mother of someone's child is the fact that I always have to take the higher road. I always have to be the one to compromise. I always have to be the one to sacrifice for her. For the betterment of her life, I have to be the one to sacrifice. Why is it never the other way around? Why don't you have to sacrifice anything? Why don't you have to give in a little sometimes? Because you fucking don't. You never do, and you probably never will. You're stubborn as shit. And I just don't get why dads act like that.
There's a lot of guys that take care of their kids, but for some odd reason, y'all always find these guys that just don't want kids and give them kids. And then so-called, they want kids, but they're not responsible. But they wasn't responsible before they didn't have kids. Like, before the kids came, he was still unresponsible. Why did you think he'll become more responsible in the relationship? You know, like, there'd be a lot of so many questions you ask, like, what makes you think all this? But they're quick to open the legs and give somebody a child.
I don't get that. It's like I always have to, like, give in. I always have to let this man have his way, and I hate that. Just because I want her to be at peace, because I want other people to be at peace. I don't... It's like, why can never, like, even when situations are against me, even when I'm hurting, and it's stuff that, like, damages me and traumatizes me, I still have to give in. And I hate that. I mean, of course, I'm gonna do anything for my daughter, anything to make her happy, anything to keep her life at peace. But I just hate that I'm in this situation. And people could say, oh, yeah, you chose to be a baby. I didn't choose to be a baby mama. I didn't choose to be a single mom. I didn't choose that. It was just what the fuck happened.
There is no such thing as a child just popping up. Kids don't pop up out of thin air. I have about 7 sisters. None of the kids just popped out of thin air. I have 7 sisters. None of my nieces, my nephews, none of them just popped out of thin air. None of them. There was a whole process. My sister met a man. She got with a man. She laid with a man. Did what adults do. She got pregnant. She chose to keep the child. She chose to give birth to a child, knowing that the guy wasn't the right guy. That's how the child came about. That's the process of most of my sisters. Like, some are, that's the process of most of my sisters. It was never just a child popped up. It was like, oh, you know, no. It was, if I get a woman pregnant today, she finds out she's pregnant. She has a choice. Does she want to keep or not keep the child? This is all a choice. This is all a choice. When it gets to a point where she's about to give birth to a child, that's already happening. It's like, you still have, I don't recommend it, but they still have other alternatives and stuff like that. If you don't be a mother and stuff like that, but you choose to be a mother. Nobody's forced to be a mother here. Women are choosing to be mothers. And there's women that choose not to be mothers. Like, women are here saying that, you know, I don't want to be a mother. There's a group of women that say, I don't want to have kids. They're making that decision. So, if they can make that decision, what's stopping other women from not saying they don't want kids? Like, it's a choice. It only becomes a bad choice when you realize you picked the wrong man. That's when you upset. Oh, nah, you know, just no. Like, it was a bad choice from day one. You knew that man before we knew him. You knew him before we knew him, and it didn't take us long to realize, nah, that's not it. Before you even speak, we look at him, we're like, no. And you want to tell us all about this and no. We don't got to hear the story. We say no, just from the appearance. We say no. But, you know, you gave him a child, you know, like you gave him a child. Like, no woman out here no woman on this planet has to give us a child. You have to choose to give us a child. You don't have to do anything you don't want to do. Giving us a child is a choice. Like, giving us a child is a choice. Like, it's not something that you just be like, oh, you know, it just happened. No, giving us a child is a choice. So if a woman have a kid, she chose to have a kid. Kids don't pop out of thin air. You decide to give out a kid. And you just happen to, and it only gets, like I said, they only regret the situation when the man doesn't turn out to be the man that they want. That's when they'd be like, oh, I should never did. Not nah, well, you knew who he was before we knew. So you still gave him a child. And it just happened. Nothing just happens. We make choices. We're human. We got free will. Choices.
I didn't choose to be a single mom. I didn't choose that. It was just what the fuck happened. And it's what I have to deal with. But I'm still going to complain. I'm still going to say how much I hate it here. Because I do. I never met somebody who makes your life as difficult as a baby daddy. Nobody in my life, nobody, enemies in high school, nobody has ever made my life this difficult. Ever.
You was going through the difficulties when you was dating him. These difficulties didn't start when you had kids with him. You had these problems when you was dating him. And I don't know what happened, but you had these problems while you was dating him. And you got to a point where you was like, you know, I'm going to give him a child. The difficulties got worse. So it wasn't like it got better. It got worse. And you had other guys. Here, I will tell people this, guys. Y'all understand this. Most of the women that you deal with, that they sit here and say all this and they cry like this. You got to understand, there was other guys that dated. They didn't give that man no kids. Think about it. These women dated other men. No kids. What made him stand out that he deserved a child? Because that man is not her only body. And I want y'all to think about it, y'all. I don't want y'all to think I'm joking or playing. Think about that. You're sitting there looking at this woman. You're like, he's not your one and only body. You have other guys you laid in bed with. What made him stand out from all of them that you said he deserved a child and they didn't deserve a child? Something about him made her say, I'm giving him a child. Compared to all other guys, because women have slip-ups sometimes. They date a guy, you know, they thought about it, you know, I was going to give him a child. I didn't give him a child, but she rejected all the other guys. But for some odd reason, she said, you deserve a child from me. And we got to ask, what made him stand out? All the other guys was no, but he was a yes. And they want to cry. Man, don't fall for that nonsense. Don't fall for that nonsense, because it's like, again, she chose that man. Out of every man she ever been with, she chose to give him a child. Now she's crying about her decision. That's your decision. You gotta live with it. You didn't have to give him nothing, but you decided you gotta live with it.
So on today's episode of Baby Daddy Bashing, I'm drinking a Red Bull. Why, you may ask? Because I didn't get no sleep last night. Why didn't you get no sleep? Because my baby daddy thought it was a good idea to come to my house at 1 o'clock in the morning and just disrupt me. And you might be asked, oh, it's just your baby daddy. Why does it matter? Mind you, we have not dated, talked. We haven't been together in any way, shape, or form in many, 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 many months. We have barely communicated because he has hated me because I applied for child support, which don't even know what's going on with that because I'm not receiving nothing. But it's like, you just hated me. And as far as the past couple weeks have gone, it has been a lot more cordial. There's been, you know, some communication about our kid, nothing out of line too far. And then yesterday, he just wants to blow me up and text me and like harass me about getting back together. That's not going to make me want to be with you. If anything, it's going to make me hate you more. I don't hate him, but it's bothering me. Like, you're being weird.
The video is called Baby Daddy Bashing. The intro to the video is called Baby Daddy Bashing. Just letting y'all know, that's the intro to the video, Baby Daddy Bashing.
He caught all my family members blowing their phones up, texting them. He texted people I have talked to in the past and someone I'm talking to currently. Like, how is that mentally sane?
You gave him a child. She gave him a child. She knew he was unhinged, mentally unstable, and she decided, you deserve a kid. You know, You don't look like you got nothing going on with your life. You mentally unstable. Why not give you a kid? What's wrong with that? Why not give you a kid? You know, you look like you're going to be a good father.
How is that okay? How do you fix your fingers and your mouth to do and say these things on your phone? Like, I don't get it. Like, literally harassing everybody I know yesterday and then showing up on my doorstep at 1 a.m. I don't get how that was even. And then begged me. He came at my door, begged me to lay in my bed with me and my baby. I have not laid in a bed with this man in I don't know how many months. I would say we tried from January to about.
You can never take women like this serious. It's like everything to her is a joke. You can never take women like this serious. It's like everything to her is a joke. And she's trying to get sympathy from all the single moms and all the nonsense people on TikTok. Some people just, it's amazing. It's amazing. It's amazing. It is amazing.
July to make it work. After that, after our daughter's birthday, we both kind of gave up. So I don't get why now that I've fully given up, you want to try harder. The past couple of weeks, months, whatever, he's been buying me flowers, bought me balloons for my birthday, bought me a cake, like trying to serenade me and like do all this stuff. But it's like, you missed out. He talking about he planned a trip for me for my birthday. I don't want to go nowhere with you. I'm cool. I'm done. You need to be done. And I'm making this so that you can feel embarrassed. And I am bashing you because it's ridiculous how unsafe I felt last night. I couldn't even sleep. That's mentally insane.
So y'all understand why we don't recommend single moms. We have no hatred towards single moms. No real like bias or complaints like crazy, but just like it's too much. It's too much. The decision she made, like it's the baggage is ridiculous. And she'll be telling guys, you know, oh, you know, I worked on myself. It's not that serious. You know, me and my baby daddy's not together. Like, and then you'll find out they were just together a few months ago. Like recently, it wasn't that long ago. Like they were just together. And she doesn't take being like, there's nothing serious about this woman. There's nothing serious about this woman. Habits, characteristics, speech pattern, nothing is serious. She's dealing with an unserious man and she's an unserious woman and she gave him a child and she's out here thinking everything's going to be rainbows and flowers and all this. Like, these women know who they get in bed with. We don't know, guys. We, the outer people, don't know. But that woman knows who she's laying in bed with. But when she tell you the story of who she's laying in bed with, it's a whole nother story. It's a whole nother story. Oh, he was this. He was this. This story only comes about after she starts realizing, I don't want to be with him. When she was with him, none of these stories came up. You couldn't tell her nothing. That was her man. But when now she don't want to be with him, he was this, he was this, he was narcissist, he was manipulating, he was controlling, he was abusive, violence, this. And it's like, once she's not with you, there's 1,000 things she'll say about you. But when she's with you, she barely say anything about, everything's good, you know, I'm happy and stuff. You could tell her, I don't think that's the right, y'all don't know him like that. And then when it gets bad, she want to tell you 1,000 stories. We don't care. Is guys, like I said, I have no problem with single moms, just that's too much, guys. That's way too much. To accept that is way too much. Way too much. You're gonna lose your hair dealing with stuff like this. You're gonna sit there and be like, well, why would I put myself through this? Like, it's